kids, we will learn about directions and their usage in reading of maps in this video today. One day, Bablu and Raju found the map of Champapur. They both were really excited about the map. Both Raju and Bablu started looking at their maps.
Raju, how interesting is this map? With this, we can find the way to any place in our village.
Yes, Bablu. See how the house of Khan is towards the south of your house.
How did you find that out, Bablu? And what does towards the south mean?
Oho, Bablu. Can't you spot the compass given on the map?
No. Where is that?
Then Raju took a look at Bablu's map.
Now I get it. There is no compass given on your map. But take a look. A compass like this is given on every map.
Saying this, Raju showed Bablu the compass drawn on his map.
But how are we supposed to use this? And what directions are these, Raju?
Then Raju explains it to him.
There are four cardinal directions: north, south, east and west, referred by north by N, south by S, east by E and west by W. They can be written like this too.
But how are we supposed to recognize these directions?
Now confused Bablu asks Raju.
This is very easy. Suppose you are looking at the direction where the sun rises. So you are looking towards the east direction. West will be towards your back. South would be towards your right hand. And the north would be towards your left hand.
But Raju, there is no sun shown on this map. Then how did you recognize the directions?
Look, this is called a compass. Using this, we can determine the directions on any map. There is an arrow like this on it. The head of it always points towards the north and end towards the south. Towards the left of north is west and towards the right is the east direction.
Bablu gets really excited.
This is really interesting. Come on, Raju, let's play a game. You tell me the name of any place in the village and I will tell you it is in which direction from my house, okay?
Is that so? Then tell me, if you have to go to Golu's dairy from your house, you will go in which direction?
So this is my house and this is Golu's dairy. If the direction towards the front of my home is north and to left would be west direction. Golu's dairy is towards the west from my home. So to go there, I will go towards west.
Very nice, Bablu. This is absolutely correct. Now tell me, the well is towards which direction from my home?
This is your home. And this is the well. The well is above your home on the map, which means according to the compass, the well is towards north from your house.
Bablu's answer is absolutely right. Kids, can you make use of the compass to complete the table? You can pause the video to find the answer. Very nice, kids. You have answered all of them absolutely right. Park is towards south of the pond. Jungle is towards east of the park. Meenu's house is in the north of Raju's house. And Uncle's house is on the west of Raju's house. Raju and Bablu are playing their interesting game. You too can play it with your friends using the map of Champapur, making questions of your own about directions. So kids, in this video, we learned about directions and the use of the compass. Kids, in this video today, we will learn more about reading a map. Everyone from school went on a trip. But being sick, Chanda could not go on the trip. While returning, Appu brings for Chanda a map of that place. He wanted to tell Chanda about what he saw there. Appu goes to Chanda's house and now he's showing her the map. He told her that at first the bus stopped at the parking. Since the journey was a long one, so everyone was hungry. So they started looking for a canteen. Kids, can you tell towards which direction is the canteen from the parking? Absolutely correct. Towards the north. Kids, can you see the compass that is made on the map? Everyone walked towards the north and reached the canteen. There they had some delicious food. Some of them went towards the cricket ground and some came to the library to check out the exhibition. Chanda was surprised to see the cricket ground on the map. She told Golu how the library looked much smaller than the cricket ground. So can he tell her the area of the cricket ground is how many times that of the library? Come, let's help Chanda to find the answer. Kids, do you remember the process of finding the area of any given place using the method of squares? In this process, we can find the area of any given place using the number of similar squares that the respective place has. If we look at the cricket ground, it is made of 12 squares, while the library is made of only 4 squares. So, in this way, the area of the cricket ground is 12 square centimeter, while the area of the library is 4 square centimeter. So, now can you tell how many times is the area of the cricket ground more than the area of the library? You can pause the video to find the answer. Absolutely correct, children. The area of the cricket ground is 3 times the area of the library. Chanda is surprised to know how big the cricket ground is. Golu tells her that there is another place bigger than the cricket stadium and asks Chanda to tell the name of the place whose area is the biggest. Kids, can you also find that place with Chanda? That's correct. The area of the garden is the biggest. Chanda tells Golu that she can spot roads everywhere. There is at least one road near every place. Then Golu tells her there is one place besides which there is no road. Can you find that place on the map? That's right. There is no road near the pond. Golu tells Chanda
that they played the game of hide and seek too. Golu was hiding behind the gate of the playground, and Sher Khan was hiding in the place right in front. Can you tell which was the place where Sher Khan was hiding? Absolutely correct. Right in front of the playground is the park. Sher Khan was hiding inside the park. Chanda also felt as if she had gone to the trip too. For this, she thanked Golu a lot. Kids, you can pause the video and play the game of question answers with your friends too. Kids, in this video, we learned about reading a map. Children, in this lesson, we will learn about the scales on maps. For Tufan Tortoise's birthday, Babble Duck Uncle sent some sweets with Golu Panda. Uncle gave Golu a map from his house to Tufan Tortoise's house, which was marked with a dotted line. Can you tell through which places will Golu pass on the way? If you want, you can find the answer to this question by pausing the video. Great kids! Your answer is absolutely correct. Golu went on his way. After a while, he got lost. That's when he saw Meenu on the way. He asked Meenu for directions. As soon as Meenu saw the map, she told Golu that he would have to go about 4 kilometers more. Golu was shocked to hear this. He told Meenu that he had walked 1 centimeter on road number 1 as per the map given by Uncle. But he could not see Appu's confectionery far and wide. Meenu then draws Golu's attention to the scale written on the map. On the scale, it was written 1 centimeter equals 2 kilometer. What is this? Is this a scale? What is a scale? Children, have you seen a map? Do you know about the scale on the map? Meenu is explaining to Golu that because in reality paths are really long, we cannot show their length on a small paper. Therefore, we use scale. As written on this map, 1 centimeter equals 2 kilometer. What could it mean? This means that 1 centimeter of map is equal to 2 kilometers on the earth. Do you know how we can use this scale? The distance of road number 1 on the map given by Uncle is 2 centimeter. How many kilometer on earth is 1 centimeter according to scale written on the map? 2 kilometer. What is the distance of road number 1 in this way? 2 times 2 equals 4 kilometer. Golu is happy and at the same time sad about the scale because he would have to walk far enough to reach Appu's confectionery shop. Walking on road number 1, Golu finally reached Appu's confectionery. He bought sweets from there for Tufan. Can you tell which road Golu will have to walk next? Look at the map and tell. Alright, Golu now has to go to road number 2. Now can you tell the distance of road number 2 using the scale on the map? You can find the answer by pausing the video. Kids, Your answer is absolutely correct. The distance of road number 2 is 8 km. Here the distances of all the roads coming in the way of Golu are shown in centimeter. Now, can you identify the longest road on the way? Now use the scale to tell the distance in kilometer of the longest road. You can pause the video and find the answer. Yes, your answer is absolutely correct. Road number 6 is the longest road and its distance is 10 km. Will Golu get lost ever again? What will happen with Golu? We will see in next video. Children, in this lesson, we learned about the scale on the maps. Children, in this lesson, we will see use of scale and direction in the maps. One day, Bablu reached the village of Ulta Pulta. As soon as he reached the gate to go inside, he found a map which was upside down. Bablu was extremely naughty. He immediately went inside the village, but there was nobody in Ulta Pulta village. He got a little scared and wanted to come out of the same gate where he entered from, but it was closed. Then he recalled that he has a map of the Ulta Pulta village. But Bablu did not know how to read the map. Can you help Bablu to get out of the Ulta Pulta village? Pause the video and look for a way to get out of the village. Absolutely right. Bablu can use any of these routes to get out of the Ulta Pulta village. Here, the length of paths of Ulta Pulta village is written in centimeters. If Bablu is standing near the gate going in, so can you find the shortest way to get out of it using the scale written on the map? How long is this road? You can find the answer to this question by pausing the video. Yes, by using way 1. We can take Bablu out of the village of Ulta Pulta by the shortest route. We add the length of these 4 roads. How many centimeters will we get? 13 centimeters. Can you really tell the distance by looking at the scale written on this map? You can think by pausing the video if you want. 1 centimeter of map is equal to 5 kilometers on the earth. Therefore, how many kilometer will 13 centimeter be? 13 times 5, that is 65 kilometer. The length of the shortest route actually is 65 kilometer. Bablu was going towards the shortest path mentioned by us when suddenly he was pulled towards road number 3, towards the magical well. Now, if Bablu has 2 exit routes, are these 2 paths at equal distance? Find an answer to this question by pausing the video. Absolutely right. Both paths are exactly at the same distance. The total distance on the map is 16 centimeter. So the actual distance would be 16 multiplied by 5, that is 80 kilometer. Now Bablu tried to go out of road number 3. If Bablu is on road number 4, then which side is the magical tree? The magical tree is on the left hand side of Bablu, which means it would be on the left. Bablu crossed road number 4 in fear and also walked on road number 5 and has come to an end of it. Now Bablu is thinking which way he has to turn. Can you tell us which direction Bablu has to turn from the unique cave to road number 6? Absolutely right. Towards left. Bablu ran fast and crossed road number 6. Now, which road will he take after turning right? Road number 7. Bablu crossed road number 7 from the spot and reached the exit gate. Bablu came out of the gate and regained his strength. Kids, Bablu is thanking you for helping him. Children, in this lesson, we have seen the use of scales and directions in maps.